Donald Trump decided to take time out of his interview with Bloomberg News editor-in-chief John MiCell White this week to completely trash an entire industry of workers here in America. That's right, folks. The elitist billionaire convicted felon decided to trash American workers who he claims are doing a job so easy that a child could do it. And he's talking about a child building automobiles here in the United States. Here is what Trump said. Mercedes-Benz will start building in the United States, and they have a little bit. But do you know what they really are? Assembly, like in South Carolina. But they build everything in Germany, and then they assemble it here. They get away with murder because they say, oh yes, we're building cars. They don't build cars. They take them out of a box, and they assemble them. We could have our child do it. All right. Let's put your money where your mouth is, right, bud? How about you send Don Jr., Eric, and Barron to that assembly plant in South Carolina or one of them in Michigan, right? And let's see them build a car. You said your child could do it. You said our child could do it. So I want to see Don Jr., Eric, and Barron put together a car. And they can work together. They don't each have to build their own cars. But let's see those, well, I'm not going to insult Barron because I don't know enough about him. But let's see those other two morons try to do this skilled labor, right? You know, Donald Trump needs to win the state of Michigan. And Michigan, of course, is a massive auto manufacturing state. So insulting an industry that is part of the backbone of that state and the workers, I mean, that's just one of the dumbest things imaginable. But it becomes even dumber when you remember that this is coming from a man whose New York apartment was pure gold, down to a golden toilet, for a man that has never done a hard day's work in his life. That man has never had to do a job where you're climbing up in attics installing air conditioner vents. He's never had to work on an assembly line. He's never had blisters and calluses on his fingers. He's never had a job where you have to take a shower when you get home, okay? This man was born into a life of privilege, given $1 million by his father to start his own real estate empire. He's never had to do actual, real, back-breaking, hard work like millions of Americans have. And he has the audacity to sit there and insult an entire industry of workers. Workers that are vital to the economy of their states and to the supply chain here in the United States. This is beyond reprehensible. And luckily, of course, Vice President Kamala Harris's campaign has already seized on this, putting the clip out on social media, and hopefully they're putting it together to run in ads in Michigan and South Carolina and Alabama, all these other states where we do manufacture automobiles. Because these workers need to know what Donald Trump thinks of them. And yes, most of these workers are in red states, and they're probably going to vote for him. And even if they still do, they need to remember, they need to understand that they're voting for an elitist who thinks these people are so dumb with such easy jobs that even a child could do it. What I've been warning you all about for a long time is one degree away from becoming true. Trump made it clear he's getting revenge if he's ever back in office with his Truth Social post, all in response to the 2020 election fraud that never happened. It's the latest example of his dangerous dictator mindset as he sets the stage for a future where public dissent is not met with debate, but with prison sentences. And of course, barely any right-wing outlets are even covering this. And if they are, it's Ben Shapiro reporting on the governor of North Dakota backing Trump, while the independent Mother Jones is calling it what it is, Project 2025's plan to suppress the vote. As you can clearly see, Trump uses fear and division to rally his base,
undermine trust in institutions, and erode democracy altogether. It cannot survive on blind loyalty and echo chambers. Democracy needs independent thought and civil discourse. And I believe that's what Ground News is all about, which is why I'm partnering with them on this video. They're an app and website that actively combats authoritarianism by gathering the world's news in one place and exposing each outlet's biases. This gives us a clear picture of where our information is coming from and any potential agenda behind it. So I highly recommend checking out more gaps in coverage on Trump and even Harris for the rest of their campaign here. Avoid being manipulated by agendas you're not aware of. Go to ground.news/ROF or scan my QR code to learn more. My viewers save a massive 40% on the same Vantage plan I use for unlimited access to all their features. Plus, by subscribing, you'd be directly supporting two independent news sources, Ground News and Ring of Fire.